welcome. I would love to introduce to you today Alicia Settle, our Design Essentials Creative Educator, who will be teaching today's class. Again, my name is Rebecca Mariolis. I'm the Director of Education. But Alicia, take it away.
All right, everybody, thank you so much for joining us today, and welcome to our Strengthening Therapy System presentation. I'm so excited that you were able to join us today, and we're just gonna go over our new system that we've just launched and just share with you our product knowledge and then the proper usages for it. And you're gonna get a treat to actually get a live model today where we're gonna complete the system. When she comes out, you'll see that 3/4 of her hair has already been completed, but I'm going to complete the last quadrant and then her final style as well. All right, so without further ado, we'll just go jump right on in. Now you'll be able to see as I'm going along with some of the PowerPoint presentation there, so you'll be able to see what I'm talking about as well. So with our smooth transitions, we know that 37% of our relaxer market has gone down. So it's gone down by 37%. So I know that you're seeing in your salons that you are needing to have a service that you can offer to your natural clients or your transitioning clients. Well, this is going to be the product that's going to help you reel those clients back in to get those great services that we offer. Now, with the Strengthening Therapy System, it is great for those clients that are either transitioning from a relaxer. It's great for those clients that are natural and they want to control their hair, get more manageability, get that frizz under control. And it's also great for our relaxed or color treated clients with dry hair, that we want to just make sure that we get that hair back restructured and under control. All right, so when we think about our smooth transitions with our Strengthening Therapy System, it is a thermal reconditioning system. And the way it works is that it is, our active ingredient is cysteine amino acids. So we know that our hair is made up of amino acids, and that cysteine is gonna go in and penetrate that hair shaft, help it to elongate that hair shaft so that we have more control and manageability. And who doesn't want more manageability when we're dealing with natural hair? What it's gonna do is restructure, straighten, and strengthen that hair, and it's gonna transform that frizzy, naturally curly, multi-textured hair back into something that's more manageable. It's gonna be stronger, healthy, and more manageable. And I can actually attest to the fact that I recently got the system into my hair as well. I've been natural for a year and a half now, and I never really wore my hair straight whatsoever. I always wore what we call a twist out, so the two-strand twist. And just recently, I got the transitioning mousse applied to my hair, and I absolutely love it. My hair is very strong, curly, bouncy, and very manageable. And I would say that my hair is very dense, okay? So I love to be able to have that manageability to be able to do my hair, okay? Now, we go in, we have 4 main products in our Strengthening Therapy System. The first one would be our sulfate-free cleansing shampoo. That's our Strengthening Therapy sulfate-free shampoo. Now with that shampoo, that is a gentle cleansing shampoo that's going to be utilized before the client receives the service, and also is going to be utilized during when they come back for their maintenance, or what you would retail to your clients to utilize to maintain their system and their hair. Now that is gentle cleansing. It's going to offer a light moisture that's going to prep that hair for the application of the product. Now the next one would be our transitioning mousse. With the transitioning mousse, we think about, we have the transitioning mousse and the elongation mousse. The transitioning mousse would be considered our regular strength, and our elongation mousse would be considered our mild strength. Now, let's go into who they're for. The transitioning mousse is great for that client that is natural. When I say natural, she's either relaxer free or she's transitioning from a relaxer to natural hair. Now with that transitioning mousse, this is going to be for that client that usually wants to wear her hair straight most of the time. Now with the elongation mousse, the elongation mousse is great for that client that is our curly girl. That's one that wears their hair mostly in curly styles most of the time, and they want to control the swelling, control the frizziness, control the reversion of it from the humidity, and they just want that control. They're seeking that control with their hair. Both of them are going to afford you that opportunity. Now the next product, the fourth product, is our silkening spray. The silkening spray is great for the client that is relaxed or color treated. Now what that's going to do is going to help restore that hair. Sometimes we know the hair may be a little weakened, and if it's weakened, you know, we want to strengthen it. With using that silkening spray, we're going to do that by giving them at least a minimum of 3 applications, and that's going to be when they come in for their shampoo and style, and that's going to be considered a conditioning treatment for them. And then you're going to see just from that first application that they're going to have strengthened effects and sealed shiny hair. All right, so those are the 4 products: the cleansing sulfate-free shampoo, the transitioning mousse, the elongation mousse, and the silkening spray. All right, now with our cleansing shampoo, sulfate-free shampoo, we have different steps that we do for the system. Now, either system, you're gonna do basically the same steps, and that's gonna be, we're gonna shampoo that hair with the cleansing sulfate-free shampoo, get a clean palette first. After that, we are going to part the hair into 4 quadrants, and then we are going to start applying the product from the nape in 1/4-inch sections using 1 to 2 pumps of the mousse. When we utilize the 1 to 2 pumps, I guarantee you guys, you don't need to use more than that. 1 to 2 is going to be sufficient. You're going to use that from the root down to the tip of the hair and then go on to the next parting. You're going to do that to the entire head form. All right. After you've done that, you're going to place a plastic cap on the hair and you're going to allow it to process for 15 minutes. Once you allowed it to process for the 15 minutes, we are going to air form the hair or blow dry the hair in manageable sections throughout the hair until we've actually gone through the entire head form. After we have done that, we will go in using 1/8-inch partings and flat iron the hair. We're going to flat iron the hair using 340 to 400 degrees. 340 to 400 degrees temperature. And then after we've done that, we're going to shampoo that hair again with our sulfate-free cleansing shampoo, followed by our express conditioner. And then we will use, after we've rinsed the express conditioner, we're going to spray in some HCO, and then we're going to proceed to styling with the style that you want to do that particular day. Now, I know I've said a mouthful and I've gone through, you know, all of the steps, but fortunately, you are going to be able to see me go through one quadrant with those particular steps, so you'll be able to put it all together because we are visual people. Now, we've talked about the products, the cleansing sulfate-free, the transitioning mousse, the elongation mousse, and our silkening spray. Now, the client that is going to be coming out today, she's actually been natural for about 4 to 5 years. And what's happened is she wears her hair mostly straight, and you'll see that she has had, she'll have some of her ends are straight. And you may notice that as a natural, if you're natural yourself, or as a stylist, you've seen your clients this way. If we have been getting thermal straightening for a while, sometimes those ends would remain straight. And we just want to make sure, you know, she wants still some more control because she sees that it's kind of swelling on her and she just wants to have that manageability for herself when she's at home to maintain it. And she wants to make sure that, you know, when she goes out and in some high humidity or for working out, if she gets a light sweat, she just wants to make sure that it's going to be manageable for her. All right, so with her texture, she's curly to tightly curled. We know that in one head form, there may be 2 to 3 different textures in one head. I personally have 3. So we find usually that in the right below the apex, below the occipital bone, right there in that back of the head, we usually find that that area is a little tighter anyway. So that's going to give us one of our curl textures or curl patterns that we're looking at. We want more manageability, and that's really the basic thing that we're going to focus on, is just knowing that once we apply this process that we're going to have the manageability of it. It's very safe, it's very effective. Both the transitioning moves and the elongation moves, they are only 1 to 2 on the pH scale. So 1 to 2 on a pH scale, we know that it is acidic. And when we apply the product, we will use gloves. Now, the only reason that I'm using the gloves is because it is an acidic product, and we think about lemons. Let's associate lemons with it. If we always work with lemons and lemons more like all day, we would find that our skin would become a little dry or a little irritated possibly. So that's why we want to wear the gloves. As I stated before, it is not a chemical, okay? This is, my hair is natural, it's remained natural. It's just basically, I feel like it's got a super boost from getting my transitioning mousse and my strengthening therapy. So I love to be able to represent something that I can actually use myself and then show you a live model as well. All right, so our client, Arda, she's gonna come out shortly. With our, just going to an elongation mousse, I told you about the steps with our transitioning mousse. Now with the elongation mousse, you can do one of two things. Now, you're able to do the steps that I just explained earlier with the transitioning mousse, but with the elongation mousse, say you have a client that is curly, and she mainly wants to wear her hair curly all the time. And she's concerned possibly that if she gets the thermal straightening process, that her hair may go a little straight on her. I mean, we've all experienced it. You know, everybody's hair is different. Well, one thing you can do is instead of flat ironing the hair on that second process, once we've shampooed, applied the elongation mousse, allowed it to sit for 15 minutes, and then we go into air form, I can air form or blow dry that product in, and from that step, I can go ahead and take her to shampoo and condition and style. All right, so I'm gonna say it one more time. She's able to be shampooed, the elongation mousse applied, I'm going to blow dry it or air form it into her hair, and then I'm going to go ahead and take her to the process to shampoo and condition and style in her curly state. Now that is that's something that you are able to do when you are trying to, you know, if you have a client that is, you're concerned, or either she's concerned that her curl pattern will be stretched a little too much, you can do that. All right? Now let me just go into a couple of things. People will always ask, can I do a color? You are able to do a color 1 week before or 2 weeks after. I'm gonna repeat, 1 week before or 2 weeks after. There's no way around it. We have tested, it's tried and proven that, you know, it's, you receive optimal results when you do it 1 week before or 2 weeks after. Now, when you do that, you wanna make sure that if you do it 2 weeks after, that we're going to put the color in one to one and a half shades darker. And I'm saying that because you want that color to penetrate. And right now, it's sealed with the cysteine amino acids. Those simple amino acids have penetrated that hair shaft. It's filled it all up. It's elongated. It's made it straight and manageable for us. And when we try to go ahead and put color in there, it has nowhere to go. So that's why we're telling you not to put it in. You cannot do it, and don't do it on the same day, okay? 1 week before or 2 weeks after.